Hello, hello! Perfidious Pete here, freshly truncheoned and ready to start busting a few skulls down in the blighted barrows of Perfidious Manor in Darga's dungeon. That's right, last episode we got ourselves a brand new wampum stick for our old friend Henry Blank here, picked ourselves up a cudgel weight, and now our houndmaster is going to be equipped to smack more bitches than a brass-knuckled Chris Brown at speed dating event. He's going to be womping them. He'll be laying down the hits like a coked-up Charlie Sheen at a two-and-a-half-men rap party. It's going to be beautiful. Not the Charlie Sheen thing. I mean, what our houndmaster is going to do to her. The Charlie Sheen thing is despicable. Don't confuse me. And you know what? I've probably made enough cracks about domestic abuse. Let's turn to having our seekers abuse some enemies down in the dungeon instead, shall we? We'll grab a team, we'll put them together, and we'll have them go down into the dungeon here and wail on a few monsters like Ike on Tina. All right, what do we got? Darkest Dungeon, still off limits. Okay, Ruins, what do you got? A moon ring, which is bad and we don't want it, although we do still need some crests. What else have we got here? Berserk Charm, not really interested. Portraits, we do need some portraits because we got to upgrade. We need to upgrade our skills, and you guys didn't see this, but between episodes, we did do a few upgrades. We upgraded all the weapons on these. Didn't actually happen in between episodes. I started recording one, and then Darkest Dungeon crashed. So some of those changes are still in it. What's going on here, the Darkest Dungeon? Oh, right. You won't go in it because, yeah, we're okay. Never mind. So anyway, Darkest Dungeon crashed between episodes. Now I'm all discombobulated. This has crests and deeds, which we also need because we also want to upgrade our blacksmith so we can get our armor to level 5. The wounding helmet is pretty good. I don't want to fight the Brigand 8-pounder at the moment, though, because that fight's going to take 2.5 hours, and we really don't have the ideal team for that. We have, you know, this team is not terrible for that. They're not good at it, but they're not terrible either. We could have Trinity doing some big damage, Russell Franklin contributing some, like, debuffs and marks, Primrose Everdeen then capitalizing on those marks, Rita Morgan. I'd really rather have a leper, but maybe we'll do that on another day, because we have a town event, and I really want to get down into the cove. 33% resolve EXP in our cove, bonus damage in the cove, and the reason I want to knock this out, there's a pretty good mission here in the cove for this Book of Sanity. Again, I already looked at all these missions because episode that crashed, you know, lost footage and whatnot. I've already decided what I'm going to do. I'm just portraying it in a fact like I'm still making up my mind. But in fact, I already know what I'm going to do. This team is going to go down into this dungeon. You know what? I'm just going to stop beating around the bush. What am I? Ike Turner? No. Beating around the bush when you throw Ike Turner in there suddenly has some very odd connotations. Like he's striking Tina, but specifically in her genitals. Yeah. But you know what? Never mind. Let's not gild the lily any additional there. Let's get a team and let's just do this. It's going to be Dwayne Hicks. We're taking old Henry Blake down there. Podman Amidala is going to be bringing up the rear. Caitlin Stark. Our camping skills and everything are already good, but we do need to get these guys equipped with trinkets, so let's do that. Unequip everything and sort them by rarity, if you would. Okay, good. Holy orders, and I think probably just commander's orders for our crusader then. Henry Blake, we're going to give you this cudgel weight. And what else should we give you? Cudgel weight's good. Bonus stun skill chance, that's handy. Anything we could do that gives you more damage or the potential to maybe scout better, since this is a gathering mission, and it is the cove, which is dangerous, and also a champion mission, which is excruciatingly dangerous. I kind of want to avoid his fights as often as possible. Crescendo box. Feather crystal would not be terrible. Likewise, this ethereal crucifix would not be bad either. We could get by with either of them. Don't we have an item that gives us bonus scouting? Book of Intuition. That gives us a reduced chance to be surprised. I would really rather not. I don't care about that. We could go for the Houndmaster's Whistle, which is not good, but it's not terrible. Or we could take the Scouting Whistle. Oh, that only works in the dark? Plus 30% scouting chance if our torch is below 51%. Oh, well, that's terrible then. Oh, we'll take this Ethereal Crucifix then and just call it a day. Caitlin Stark, nothing fancy out of you. You're getting your standard gear here that tools up your blight and makes you amazing. And it's a Sacred Scroll and Junia's Head then for the good old garden variety Padme Amidala. And that's our team. Let's get some provisions in us. So we got a medium length champion dungeon, but this is a champion dungeon. I'm going to go ahead and take 2 full stacks of food here. The maximum amount of food allowed. Medium length dungeon, I think we probably get by with 3 shovels. We're down in the cove, so you know what? Let's not buy an anti-venom. 1 anti-venom for trinket interaction is really probably all we're going to need. We'll grab a bandage, one medicinal herb, one key, and I think we take our standard 14 torches. Let's do this. We already have, I mean, we have to gather things. We already have those stupid dog biscuits loading us down. Oh, geez, the pea dog biscuits, really? Are they that big a burden? You can just fit them in your pocket so you can give your friend a tasty treat. Yeah, yeah, you walk around with dog biscuits in your pocket all day, and all you're going to do is have dogs sniffing at your junk. Now, if that's your goal, be like, oh, of course I keep dog biscuits in my pocket. I like to have dogs sniff at my junk. Well, then, well played. If it's not your goal, though, you know, think about the consequences of your actions. Recover these lost shipments of rarities. So scouting early is delightful. We've got a curio. Room battle with treasure. We want to avoid battles, though. I'm tempted to slip out and try and... You know what? In fact, I'm beyond tempted. We're going to slip out and snag this curio. You are coral. Coral. Eerie coral is bandages? Nope. Definitely anti-venom, then. Right? Nope. How come I can never remember what coral is? Is it a shovel? It's not a shovel. Is it a shovel? Beautiful. Well, okay, so we wasted all of our consumables for no net gain. I am the greatest Darkest Dungeon player who has ever lived. We're back in our main room. Glad we went out of our way to try and get that curio. It cost us some torchlight. We threw away two of our consumables, and we actually, the interaction that we got gave us stress. So all things considered, that went as bad as it could have possibly gone. A little bit of stress relief there for Henry Blake on the disarm, and we're going to be picking a fight here in just a moment. Okay, first battle, nothing too terrible. Got a stress-causing unit, a little bit of shocker. He's going to put the hit to... Well, the critical is unpleasant. Mostly for the stress, but the stun is also unfortunate. Comes an eldritch push. If you push me back, I'm just going to... Okay, you're just getting Holy Lanced. You asked for that one, Cultist Witch. You brought that on yourself. So what are we going to do? We're going to stun that Cultist Witch because I don't want to get hit by any more stress attacks. I'm not really concerned too terribly about damage. I just don't want to take a bunch of stress. 25 big old damage from Dwayne Hicks. Taking 8, coming back with the bleed as well. Alright, and the enemies are working us over a little bit. You're stunned, so I'm not going to focus on you. I think what we're going to do is go ahead and heal. Our girl Caitlin Stark is going to get this guy down, and you're taking a nice cudgel weight to the face. It's going to get you stunned. We're already getting some serious mileage out of old Henry Blake. Go ahead and dot you up, although the hit killed you as opposed to the dot. We're going to take another salty gouge. That's 4 and a bleed, which we resisted the move, didn't resist the bleed. Not really that worried about it. If that bleed becomes a problem, we can cure it ourselves. Your stun has worn off. All right, let's go ahead and give me... How much health have you got? 26. You have 38. Give me a... Let's try and kill one of these units. That's a pretty good start. We've left you with 8 health. These jellyfish got crazy speed, though. 8 damage and a bleed. We're now bleeding 7 per for 3 rounds. That bleed is friggin' enormous. We gotta get rid of that. Battlefield bandage heals us, too, if we... that's actually pretty awesome. Let's go for our AoE heal. And Henry Blake, I can't help but notice that you're not getting much accomplished here, champ. We can't really hounds rush from where we are. We could target whistle. I say instead, we just wallop this guy. That gets the stun on him, puts him a little bit closer to death. Blake with the dank dodge! You cannot touch Henry Blake. Contractually, you don't get to kill him off camera because it's going to make the audience absolutely furious when you do that. Rent for the old gods. 4 damage, resisted to bleed, thanks to our brand new trinket, I'd like to point out. We're going to stack you up with some blight. I think we just go for the wallop here. And Dwayne Hicks, you know, I feel like maybe a little stress relief is in order. Let's drop one on Padme, get her a little bit of that stress back. And Padme, you're going to AoE heal. Nice critical as well, a little extra stress relief for our trouble. This guy's stunned. We're going to tag him up with some more blight. Not quite fatal damage yet, but we're getting close. His stun wears off. He dies next turn, so we have really no need to mess with this guy. Let's just restore our party to order. Get a little bit more stress healed off of Padme, and we let this guy drop dead at the top of the turn. We can do a little, you know what? Actually, Padme, we don't need the heal. Why don't you go ahead and murder this man? If you can. All right, well, we threw the attack, but he dodged. I would love to go for a stress relief here, but we don't really have the opportunity. Let's see if we can't beat this guy on a speed roll with our Crusader, though, and get one more chance for a little bit of stress relief. One last chance to relieve that stress. Nope. Well, it was worth a shot. Hey, we got a blue for our trouble. Life crystal, bonus max HP, not that good. Little bonus food. More, we've got four busts. We're not really in the market for busts at the moment, but we can always trade those in. Two busts is like, a third of barnacle crusted chest. We're down to two shovels. You know what? See if somebody gets a nasty gash from this. Nope, no nasty gash for us. We got straight up booty, yo. In we go. This is the most dangerous fight in the cove right here. Four attacks from these guys can kill pretty much anything. I do appreciate the fact that they're swinging at Dwayne Higgs. No criticals. Okay, that's terrible. Just not again, then. Okay. So we got to get kills engineered on some of these fishmen, and we got to start doing it as quickly as possible. That's a hell of a start. Nice critical, getting a little bit of that stress back as well. We could go for the triple stun, and in fact, I think we do. This man gets a club to the face. We give him the old fish bat. We give him the gaff, as it calls. Wait, is the a gaff is a hook. What's the thing they use to smash fish in the head to kill them? It has a name. It's like, there's a particular name for the device. I just don't remember it. Damn it, Padme. We needed that to hit because you need healed. So we're going to start dotting these guys in the back up. They do have a stun going on this turn. They're going to take five. Stun's going to wear off. In the meantime, I think we just bite this man. Did not get the kill, but a bleed could finish him. Nope. Seaward slash then for Dwayne Higgs. Higgs taking... He's taking a lot of damage here. A lot of damage. We gotta get some kills here. And we have to go for a directed heal on Dwayne Higgs. He's real banged up. Give me the Jacques though. There it is. The double kill from the Jacquesation. This fight is so dangerous right now. Unfortunately, it does kick us out of the position where we're going to be able to blight both of those guys. Not fatal damage yet. That was another Seaward Slash. Higgs takes another 11. Give me the kill. If we could have killed that man, I would have absolutely preferred to have done it, but we didn't have the opportunity. We are going to be able to stun him, though. There's a strong chance Henry Blake can keep this guy locked down in for the entire duration of the time it's going to require us to kill him. We're going to throw a heal at Padme. First, I don't want her to be capable of being sent to death's door by a single shot. We'll go ahead and give you some more blight back there. Get you good and loaded up. Not fatal damage yet. Wait a minute. How come? Well, that's why we healed Padme. This guy is dead. He has fatal damage. Let's just throw a target whistle. Get the mark out of the road. Padme, physician, tend to thine own wounds. And heal herself for 10. And we're actually going to throw stress relief and healing. Nice job, Dwayne Higgs, with a timely crit. We want anything we can get. Are you kidding me? How is that not fatal damage? We've blighted that guy. You fucking shitting me. What is up with this guy? Why is he not... That unit should have had fatal damage. We had enough blight on that guy that damage should have been fatal. Well, we're in dire straits here. Put our party back in order. I'm tempted to camp, but it feels too early. I mean, we got a lot of dungeon left to go, and we haven't really even discovered a single curio yet. I'm not happy. Unlock strongbox. Dwayne Higgs, you're the only person who hasn't been hit, so why don't you set off a trap then? Beautiful. Okay, we need some scouting here, guys. We really, really could use it. Pack has already been looted. What is this little buff? Oh, right, we have the bonus damage. Bonus EXP. I'm curious if we're going to be able to get EXP even out of this. We took 4 damage, but 17 stress. What's the debuff? Minus 20 dodge, minus 5 speed. Bad, but not the end of the world. Got a fight in this room? No fight. Any scouting? No scouting. Well, ain't that a kick in the head. I don't want to come up that way if I don't have to. In all likelihood, we are going to have to go this way. Guys, though, the scouting, could somebody maybe take a freaking look around a little bit? See what the hell's going on? Because the penalty to dodge for Dwayne Higgs is not that big of a deal. We're real banged up. We should eat some food. You know what? Yeah. I don't want anybody in a capacity where they could go down from a single shot. Let's get some food in us. There we go. One more for Padme. She is our dedicated healer, and there's the scout we needed. And it's a big one. Beautiful. Okay, what do we got? A curio, a regular curio, an empty room. We got a battle, quest location, curio, curio. We're gonna have to go this way. It's locked in. We may ultimately have to wind up backtracking in this direction, but we know for certain we need to go this way. So let's do the dirty right now. This fight is unspeakably dangerous because in all likelihood, we are gonna get double roundabouted. So we need to minimize damage in any possible capacity we can. And I think now is time we eat a... So we're gonna eat a dog treat. We gotta work over the big guy. Okay, so hit the big guy. 19 damage and the bleed. That's an acceptable start. We're gonna go for the stun on these two rearward units. We gotta lock them down. Caitlin Stark getting the job done. Padme's gotta go for the dank group heal. Solid aggregate damage right there. Or aggregate healing, rather. And a big old wallop from Dwayne Hicks. That's top quality work, fellas. Top quality work right there. Now it's all about who wins the speed rolls. Dwayne Hicks isn't going to be able to dodge anything. Holy Lance. We needed to get knocked back one further to have that Holy Lance do us any good. I think we go ahead and start working these guys over with the Blight. The crit is just, you know, a nice little tangible benefit for us. Comes a blanket fire. That critical really sucks. Our stress is getting high, but more importantly, our damage is actually starting to get high. And unfortunately, now that we've been moved, we cannot hit this man. So I think we're going to Hounds Harry. We got a lot of ticking dot damage, but the dot damage isn't really doing us any good if we can't control these guys. Comes the slice and dice, 11 damage. Man, we are just getting pounded. Rain of whips. Okay, no criticals, which is the important thing. Although the bleed on this is considerable. Padme, you got an AoE heal. We are definitely going to have to camp after this one. We will not have the option. We have taken too much damage. Dwayne, thank you for the kill. I appreciate it. These guys do have a lot of damage on them. How much you got? You know what? Lock this man down. Let's hit him with the stun. He's more dangerous from a critical perspective, and also... This guy has lower hit points. He may have fatal damage. Nope, we got close but didn't quite get it. I'll take a blanket fire if I have to. We can easily undo that with a single heal from Padme. That's fatal damage on both units now. Now we got to focus on stress relief and healing. The critical is nice. Little 8 extra. We got to get rid of some of these bleeds, but Dwayne Hicks, I want you to manage your own stress a little bit and also heal up because you are the most egregiously wounded. We need our Plague Doctor to win one speed roll. Perfect. Okay, who's got the worst bleed? You're 3 for 1, so we're going to do this. Which cures 2 of those 3 bleeds. We're just going to hit you with a target whistle, because it's a non-zero chance we could get another free heal out of Padme here before you drop dead. Alright. Wasn't a good chance, but it was a non-zero chance. What can we take out of this? We want the deeds and we want the sapphires. These things must go. What debuff do we have? You have a huge bleed resist. You have... Okay. 7 rounds. We're getting rid of that. We're going to take these sapphires. More than the sapphires, I actually want the deeds. Are we going to camp here? We have to get rid of something in order to camp. What is that going to be? Padme, drink the holy water. It's super sacrilegious, I know, but it's got to be done. We need to camp, and the problem is now we can't. I'm considering doing a little backtrack. You know what? I'm beyond considering it. We're actually going to take the backtrack and camp in this room. What if the hallway battle respawns? Then we just took a bunch of stress for literally no reason. We can't fight in this condition. We can't do it. We can get rid of the stress with our camping skills. Let's just hope that hallway battle does not respawn behind us. We're done. We're camping it out. A moment of respite. Feast, get some health back. Let's work on... okay. So, Zealous Vigil. Is one way to prevent a nighttime ambush, possibly not the best way. I think we go here instead. That only prevents nighttime ambush. It does literally nothing else if we don't have mortality debuffs, which we do not. So, What have you got? Hound's Watch. Prevents nighttime ambush, also costs 4 time, and gives us a bonus chance to surprise monsters, which I kind of don't want. Release the Hound is actually quite good. Therapy Dog, all companions minus 10 strength. You know what? We definitely want a Therapy Dog. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to Zealous Vigil. That takes care of what little stress he had. Then, I think we Therapy Dog. Everybody gets rid of some stress. Now we got to start looking into maybe heals. We only have 5 time left. We could ply the leeches. Gives us a 15% heal. We could self-medicate. Gives us a 20% heal and bonus stress. We'd get rid of all of your stress almost. Or we could hit the cure, which only removes a disease. Nobody is blighted. 15% heal or a 20% heal for... You know what? Self-medicate. That's got rid of most of your stress and got you patched almost back up to full. And then we have 2 time left. What can we do with it? We could ply the leeches, give somebody a little bit of a heal. We could just encourage and get rid of some stress. We could give a little pep talk to give somebody a bonus stress resist. I really feel like maybe leeches is the way to go here, because we do have... I mean, Dwayne Hicks is real bang. You know what? Yeah. Give Dwayne Hicks... Ply the leeches. I need 9 health right now more than I need to get rid of any of Padme's additional extra stress. No worry about nighttime ambush. Our Zealous Vigil is already taking care of that. May we find victory. Torchlight back to maximum, and we're headed out back into the dungeon. But whatever we get for the rest of the dungeon, man, whatever comes in now, that's what we keep. But the camp did have one other bonus side effect. We got, you know, room now to pick up this Ancestor's Relic. It's a little fringe benefit. It's a value add, as they would say in the business world. Some value added there by our Houndmaster with that trap disarm and the free stress relief. Check out this sack. Sack is empty. Well, that's disappointing. Okay, we're going to burn 1 torch, keep our light level high. We're going to roll through here. This is actually a very tough fight for us. Especially if we wind up with a bunch of people stunned, it's going to make us unable to get that thrall. So... I think our best bet is actually to stun this man. We don't want to stun a thrall now because he will not explode on his first turn. We just want to make sure we don't get stunned in return while we hit that guy for 23 damage. That makes him pretty injured. The barnacle bearer is very unfortunate, but all we have to do is hit him with an AoE attack and we'll be okay. So what do we want to have Padme do? We definitely want to have Padme go for the heal. Just in case that thrall goes early. Taking a gargling grab, 18 damage out of that. Holy shit, that hurt. Okay, let's go for the... I mean, you have a huge stun resist, but what is your base stun resist? Yours is at 135. What's our stun chance? 129 plus 40. I mean, that's... it's respectable, but all things considered, probably not worth the risk. We're going to go for the blight instead. Okay, as long as they keep putting their shockers on units that have already gone, that's okay. We actually resisted the stun anyhow. Not Dwayne Hicks. Anybody but Dwayne Hicks. That's fine. The critical is unpleasant, but it's you know, we can overcome it. All right. I think we stunned the thrall just out of abundance. If we stunned the thrall out of him, yeah, you know what? We stunned the thrall. We knew that guy was going to step in front of it, but if he's stunned, he can't intercept attacks. We can kill the thrall. Problem solved. We also could have just stunned that guy too, but I wanted to put the damage on the thrall to make sure we got him. Little directed healing would not go awry here. That 18 damage we took from that gargling grab did not do Dwayne Hicks any favors. Okay, ticking damage, still not fatal on that guy. If we took another blight on him, however, that will be fatal damage. We are bleeding currently. Another salty gouge coming. Yep. Okay. Man, Caitlin's getting wrecked. Pretty significant bleed. I really don't want to get hit by this Octocestus. But I also... You know what? Go for the Hound's Harry. That puts fatal damage on this guy. And we can just throw a directed heal. That's the girl. Right there. Pumping Caitlyn's start back up right where she needs to be. I guess we're just going to start wailing on this guy. As much as I don't want to hit him with directed attacks... Dwayne Hicks can't really do much else. We could have him go into stress relief mode while we kill this guy with blights and bleeds, and as soon as we get rid of this jellyfish, we may do exactly that. Another salty gouge coming our way. That's okay. We resisted the bleed. I was going to have Caitlin Stark cure the bleed because we don't want to take that 20 damage. We're going to forego damage on this turn for the force of safety. Then we're going to whack this guy with the stun. And we're going to clean up the mess here with the little Jacques Hughes. Dwayne Hicks getting some trivial damage there. More importantly, getting us the kill on a jellyfish. And he now can go into full stress relief mode. That's a big heal from Padme. Padme is bringing out all of the stops here. Why is she such a great late game hitter? She's the A-Rod of Darkest Dungeon. When it's early in the game, she can't do shit. She's got no use whatsoever. If it's a close game or the game is tied, the game's on the line, she's worthless. She's worthless. But when you're doing well, she just comes in and hits 22 pointless home runs. If it's tied in the bottom of the ninth with the bases loaded and a full count, Padme Amidala is not going to get on base. She's going to strike out. See, look, but if she's up by 9 runs in the bottom of the ninth with the bases loaded, she hits a grand slam literally every time. Good for the Divine Comfort. Our Houndmaster is down a few health. And at this point, there's really no benefit into even having her continue to heal because nobody's hurt and this guy is stunned. He also has fatal damage. So we're going to go for stress relief then from Dwayne Hicks. This turned out to be a solid little fight for us. We made net gains. We got healing and stress relief while damaging our foes. Just a little make sure blight for this guy. And I don't know, maybe throw a target whistle here. We could have killed him or hit him, but I wanted to give more units an opportunity to go, and this is why. More chance for stress relief farming these critical heals. Alright, he's gonna drop dead. No free stress relief from Dwayne Hicks. All things considered, I think that's okay. Ruby's 1,250 gold a stack. That's pretty solid. Is there anything else I would like to get rid of in favor of that? I mean, we really need heirlooms. We can't afford to discard food. I honestly think maybe we throw away gold here. This is basically an even trade, but the ruby is, you know, more stacking benefit. We can stack that higher. Alternatively, we could get rid of this life crystal, because I think we already have one. Also, I'm never going to wear it. You know, I'm getting rid of the life crystal, actually. The emerald I'm just going to throw on the floor, which does make me deeply sad. Really, Pete? Throwing a trivial item on the floor in a video game is the kind of thing that makes you deeply sad? No, I mean, you know, I engage in hyperbole I was being facetious. It doesn't deeply make me sad. There are many, many other reasons in my life for me to be deeply sad. You know, doing a slightly less than 100% efficient thing in a video game doesn't make me deeply sad. It just makes me a little sad. I have no idea what the fuck you are, but I don't like you. Squiffy Ghast! You have 66 health, which is a lot. Maddening Shanty. What does that do? Stress attack? Okay, it also puts you in the front rank, which is weird. Spear Fishing, taking 10 damage. And the move, which honestly doesn't really matter much. Okay, I don't like this guy at all. I have no idea what he's capable of. I'm tempted to hit him with a stun, but I'm also tempted to go for aggregate damage with the Hound's Harry. I think that's what I'm going to do. You know what? Before we do that, now is definitely the time to eat this dog biscuit. So this squidgy ghost or whatever the hell he's called, he's probably one of the new enemies that Darkest Dungeon has added. We gotta kill this thrall because we cannot have this bastard exploding on us. Whatever this squiffy ghast is up to, we know what the thrall is up to, and he's up to way, way worse troubles. We really need to stun here, Caitlin. Okay, good, thank you. And we're gonna... There's the kill on the thrall. Alright. So the hard part, I think, or at least the most dangerous part, is over. We got the stuns on these guys. How are you? You are not blight resistant at all. This guy is still a danger, but we really need to kill the stress unit. I don't want to take a whole truckload of stress, because it seems like this guy may also have some off-kilter jig. It looks like he may also have a stress attack. We have no idea what that attack does, but I don't like the looks of it even a little. What a wallop from Henry Blake, though! 15 damage critical and the stun. That's some dank work, yo. You know what? You get 12 healing as a reward for that, Henry Blake. That's fantastic work, son. And the Jacques Hughes then. Solid aggregate damage, and that's fatal for our fishy friend here. We are going to take a seaward slash. 13 coming back at us. You have to do better than that, son. Get wrecked. All right, we're going to start stacking Blight on this guy. Yes, we could have gotten fatal damage on our fishy friend here, but I still have no idea what this guy is capable of. Mostly because everything he's throwing at us, we have successfully managed to dodge. I do not want to be getting hit by that fish man. We're just going to go for the stun. Got the kill instead, which is fine. 22 damage to your violin. I hope it's not a Stradivarius. What are you going to do from the front spot? It seems like this guy is basically a bard. Did he just... Was that previous attack he tried to hit us with solo? Maddening Shanty. That just seems like a stress attack. It's just like a low damage stress attack. It has a debuff component as well, but we can't tell specifically what it's debuffing. Why don't you be stunned? And you also have fatal damage, so we're going to take a time to do some directed healing here and then also go for a little bit of stress relief. We can undo some of the what you have caused. Padme, why don't you get a little bit back? Still has 20. Let's go for... We can pump up... Oh, the critical! The rare battlefield bandage critical, and our sea violin playing friend is now dead. Success so clearly. He wasn't really our friend. I say that. Is it merely a trick of the light? So of this, what should we do? Well, we should drink the holy water, if nothing else, to give ourselves a little stress relief. Or a little stress resist, rather. I think we leave the jade on the floor. I'm going to take medicinal herbs over jade here. We've got a potential to earn a curio interaction with that. Not a lot of curios that we can use medicinal herbs on in the cove, but still, I mean, just... Would have loved to have gotten some scouting here and potentially saved ourselves a trip. We got a lot of dungeon to backtrack over. Okay, pack contains loot. There's why we took that ruby right there. We did, in fact, make the right choice. Put our deep party back in the default order. Journals of Darius Rucker? Journals of Darius Rucker, Highwayman. Day one, the start of Darius's journey. The day he met the other members of Hootie and the Blowfish. Rare travelers on the road this autumn, and rather than starve, I pressed my last coin in the hand of one who dealt in rumors and shadows. Ah, he signed a contract with Sony Music. Yep, that's rumors and shadows, all right. Ravens carried a cryptic note that there was a person or persons who was pledging coin for services best left unmentioned in a hamlet I have never heard of. I am packing to leave immediately and form a band I'm going to call Hootie and the Blowfish. Do we actually blow fish? No, I'm not even sure that's, like, physiologically possible. I don't think fish have external genitalia. We will take your shovel. More Darius Rucker? Aw, blood-soaked pages? I don't care about those. I'm going to burn this last torch and take the 1,000 gold. A blazing star is we got a lot of backtracking to do, so ultimately that may prove to be a very suboptimal play. Well, nothing to do now but start walking. So what are we going to do about torchlight? Well, we have cleared all of this, so in theory, this backtracking is only going to cost us a tiny bit of stress for traveling and some of our torchlight. We're going to try and conserve torchlight. I won't let us dip down into full darkness because I definitely do not want to risk having an encounter with the Shambler. That would be catastrophic at this point. But I am going to let our light levels dip. These corridors are really long. We don't have to go down here, although we may nip out and try and snag this curio. Just nip out, snag the curio, and nip back. Pete, don't you think you're getting a little bit greedy here? Just a little bit greedy? You know, maybe I am getting a little bit greedy. But greed is good. This is what Gordon Gekko has taught us. We have to heed the preachings of the man himself, Gordon Gekko. Also, the lower light level gives us better loot out of this box. See, we got two portraits and a holy water. Here, you drink that. We really need this portrait, though, and so much so, I'm getting rid of those medicinal herbs. Why do you need portraits, Pete? We got, you know, we got skills and Hamlet things we got to upgrade. We still need to upgrade our trainer so that our team has the best available skills. And we have a hallway battle. All right, so a hallway battle respawn behind us. We're going to burn just one torch. This, okay, and we have surprised the enemy, which... It's not the end of the world, but it's not good. Dwayne Hicks won a speed roll. Let's see if we can kill this man. Perfect. Fantastic start. Okay. So, you're getting stunned. We're going to get 7 damage out of you. And then you two in the back, yeah, you're also getting stunned. I'm not going to let these guys double up roundabout on me. That's not going to happen. And we're going to hit you with the bolt of lightning from the blue. Between the cudgel weight and the bolt of lightning, we made a pretty good start on that guy. Three of these dudes are getting skipped on their first turn. And now we're back to just regular speed rolls. Ah, sweet dodge from Dwayne Hicks. We're back to just regular speed order here. Taking a stress wave. Padme should have some resistances to that. Yep, she's got minus 10% stress. Let's go ahead and start working some blight on those guys. Spear fishing is bad. Not critical. Okay, not a critical. Good. The move is considerably less relevant, although it does mean Padme is going to get shockered. She will likely get stunned. Yep. She's not all of our damage, so it's not the end of the world. We're going to go for the Jacques Hughes. There's two damage, but more importantly, we got the shocker taken care of. A little bit of bonus damage on our snail friend. And now, you're getting slapped in the head with a cudgel. Got a little brine squirt at us. Dwayne Hicks with another dope dodge. The guy. He's untouchable. He's gone into full rope-a-dope. Okay, well, he's rope-a-doping less. That one severed his face. Keep stacking damage on this guy. We're not to fatal territory yet. I think now is a good time for a Hound's Harry. Now, you know what? Cudgel Smash is just too good. I want the damage and the stuns. We can't go for a stun on this guy because we've hit him with it too many times. His stun resistance is off the chain. Padme missing. That's no good for anybody. Little Jacques Hughes. That's fatal damage, which means we didn't get a whole lot of mileage out of our stun other than the fact that that guy's not going to get an attack last turn. Keep sticking a blight in. Still not fatal damage. Well, he does definitely have fatal damage, but we're not going to kill him this turn. He's going to get one more shot at us. Comes a stress wave. That's fine. Henry Blake has no stress, so if anybody can afford to take it, Blake is that boy. Why don't you stun that snail? I don't feel like getting squirted with brine here, and we're going to go for stress relief on Podman. Let's grind that down a little. AoE heal just to patch us up. Nice critical for the bonus stress relief. Would have preferred you maybe hit a unit who was a little more injured with that stress relief, but beggars can't be choosers. This is fatal damage on our snail if the blight sticks, which it did. All right, we good. What do we need to do? I don't know, we'll just target this, I guess. Let's see if Hicks or Podman can get something off before this snail. And sincerely, if you guys can't beat a freaking snail on a speed roll, you gotta, you know, you have deeper issues. We need to send you in for a personal development day because you need some additional training if you can't outspeed a snail. All right, then.
This expedition at least promises success.
I think we take as much food as we can carry. We eat the last two. Actually, we can only eat one, and I don't want to carry any more. We're going to need to start shedding inventory items here at some point, and I'm thinking we really need crests. We need heirlooms way more than we need gold, although we also need gold. Maybe we ditch the key. The key is 15 grand if we find a secret room, though, Pete. It's 15 G's, dog. I make a compelling case, I have to admit. Something, though, has got to... You know what? Something's got to give. I'm sorry, skeleton key. We're not doing well in the scouting department anyway. We haven't been getting as many scouts as I might like. Let's just assume that trend is going to continue then. Gonna move to this room. We have scouted here, so we know what's going on. Got a little hunger prompt. That's fine. We have abundance of food. Check out what's in this box. The box is empty. Always hoping for Gwyneth Paltrow's head, but to date, 100% disappointed. Empty room here. How about a scout? Nope. Maximum of two rooms left to explore. Another empty sack. We probably have too many torches, given the number of rooms we have left. All right, this is a fight, but not a devastating one, especially considering we've got the cudgel weight and surprise on our side, so you're getting walloped in the face then. I love the cudgel weight. I love it. It's so good. It's so good. I think we go ahead and hit the fishman with some blight. If we had two back rain units there, I would have probably stunned the third one and then gone for the heal, but in this case... I think we just try and set up a kill on Jimmy the Fish here. And that's fatal. Blight's gonna take him out, so we've scrapped one, stunned another. This guy's surprise is gonna go. He takes a swing. Take a rend for the old gods. It sucks that it was a critical, but what are you gonna do? He got the bleed as well. I'm tempted to cure that bleed. How big? It's actually a very big bleed. I'm beyond tempted. I am going to cure the bleed. That was a 15-point bleed. That's pretty significant. And we're taking a stressful incantation as well, which also sucks. That's a lot of stress to have taken in a single fight. Okay, this guy has huge stress. No, well, I'm not taking any more stress from that bitch. We're gonna smack her in the head. Padme coming up with the A-Rod style whiff at the critical moment. Fantastic work, young lady. Wow, I was not expecting the critical there. Would have vastly have preferred to redirect that to a different target. Let's start loading this guy up then. And we're gonna work stress relief exclusively with Dwayne Hicks here. Really, Blake? That's what you're gonna throw? Okay. Trash attacks now? It's all trash attacks. Another 12 damage from a Ren for the old gods. We did resist the bleed, however, which is nice. Let's get some critical stress relief. In that both it critical and it's critical that it be done. It's doubly critical stress relief. Meanwhile, we're just going to let our blight continue ticking away. It's nice to see this guy swinging someone who is not Dwayne Hicks. He did get the bleed, however. You know what? We'll take one turn of that bleed. I feel remiss that we are not just hitting this man with a cudgel weight again and again and again. It really feels like we should just be cudgel weight until it fails. We don't have fatal damage yet. I'm going to give this guy one last shot. Or alternatively, we just beat him on a speed roll. Now he has fatal damage. And hey, bonus stress relief. We made the right choice. Little extra for Henry Blake. Just kill him then. Or let him dodge us again. Okay, that's the other option. Sure. Another sapphire. Onyx is going on the floor.
Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying.
We need these deeds. Something's got to go. You know what? I'm throwing 1,000 gold on the floor in favor of those deeds. I need the deeds more, and also something else has got to go here, too. This is a little bit of a more interesting choice. We can't get rid of our torches, because we're still going to need at least one of those. We could gamble and ditch the shovels, or alternatively, we could toss... You know what? I think we toss the busts. We don't need busts as badly as we need crest deeds and portraits. We need all of those things more than we need busts. Busts are really only useful for upgrading, like, the sanctuary. And what we need are portraits to upgrade the guild, and we need deeds to upgrade the blacksmith. Once we get our final blacksmith upgrade, though, deeds can go by the wayside, and dungeon's over anyway, so it doesn't matter. We are not going to go do that room battle, where I would rather escape unscathed. What I am going to do is pitch those shovels on the floor, take this ancestor's relic. That's quest complete. We're going to continue adventuring, though, because, hey, there's, like, free curios out here, and I'm not going to let those fall by the wayside. I'm taking those with me. Those are my curios. So, coral just gives us stress relief, right? Oh, well, that one did nothing. The one thing I remember about this is that you don't hit it with a shovel. I think this is one of the ones you just touched, though, right? Yeah. We got nymphomania, which means we get bonus stress relief if we use the brothel. Yeah, okay, it's fine. Let's just... I'm not going to go fight that final room battle. There's no bonus. There is a curio interaction in there, yes, I understand, but I'm not going to fight one fight for a curio. Unlikely that that curio interaction would get us more benefit than any potential drawbacks we might find from a fight. Like, if we get 50 stress on one person, that curio is unlikely to pay for that stress relief. 8 deeds, fantastic. 32 crests. We also got 5 busts, 2 portraits, 19,000 gold. But more importantly, we picked up our Book of Sanity. And more importantly than all of those things, we got a couple legends in here. Hells yeah. Picked up Lurker, which replaced what? Precise Striker. So that's objectively terrible in every direction. We got a downgrade. Precise Striker got replaced by something that's never going to help us. And we picked up a Wasting Sickness. On the plus side, though, nobody else got screwed, just Dwayne Hicks. And legends. The legends are here. The legends of the fall. And we got a free weapon upgrade for our troubles. We don't have anybody who can take advantage of that free weapon upgrade, I don't think. Do we? No, we have some level 3 troopers who are not rocking level 4 weapons, so let's get Nicholas Brody and just take advantage of that while we're at it. Brody? Let's get you, there you go. That'll save us some cash. It's not a huge savings, but it's something. 16 deeds is not enough. Portraits, do we have enough here? We need 33. So we're not quite home, but if we could pick up 6 from our next quest, we would be there. What's available on the stagecoach? Nothing good. Okay, then. So, that's it, then. Legends. We got some. Four of them. And possibly the team we're going to take into the first darkest dungeon? These guys seem to fire on all cylinders. They do seem to work well together. My only concern is maybe, just maybe, they don't have quite enough stress relief. But they could possibly overcome their lack of stress relief with just good, solid aggregate damage. It'll be an interesting conundrum. There's a lot of Eldritch in there, so we could get good damage out of Henry Blake, as long as we're doing directed damage. If we had a unit that could mark in that group, I'd feel more confident in sitting them in the Darkest Dungeon. But hey, that's a debate for another day, because this episode is over. If you enjoyed it, feel free to drop a like down in the comment section. Of course, your support does really mean a lot to us. And if you'd like to watch us go all Ike Turner on some monsters in the future, you might consider subscribing as well. Post new episodes of Darkest Dungeon every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. Right now, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you again soon.